Okay, anyways. But anytime this the developer would respond to somebody, like for example, somebody was having an issue with the mod and, you know, it wasn't launching or whatever, he would basically respond and say, basically call them out for being, you know, say it's nothing wrong with the mod, you need to get some education and learn how to, you know, fix your fucking computer, stuff like that, right? Every single time. There was never a peaceful or helpful thing from the developer. It was always some insult that it's not my fault, it's your computer's problem, or it's your file's problem, or it's your dumbass issue, right? And it kind of offended me a little bit, because I was like, why does this person have to be controlling such an awesome mod? Where there's well over like 500 people having this issue, and yet somehow you still feel the need to say it's not your fault, it's not something that's wrong with your mod. And sure enough, somebody finally figured out, after looking through the comments, somebody at some point finally figured out what it was. It was a certain line of code in the mod that the developer put in that for some people it doesn't work because you have to have a certain program installed. It doesn't say this anywhere in the mod description whatsoever, but all you have to do is go into the files, delete that line of code, and bam, done. It works smoothly, like a wet dream. It just kind of pissed me off a little bit that the developer was such an asshole towards everybody, saying that it wasn't his fault when it was. It was a fault of the mod, not a fault of anyone else. The thing that he had there that basically it was some sort of like physics in the game. Like it added a certain, if it updated the lighting or changed the lighting around, and if you didn't have certain things downloaded or purchased along with his mod, apparently that that means it doesn't work. But it doesn't say that anywhere in the Nexus mod description, it doesn't say that anywhere on the Steam Guide mod description, it doesn't say it on his website, it doesn't say it anywhere that this has been added. It says that it's been added in the, when you look at the update notes, but nowhere does it say, you know, you need this, or you need to, in order for the mod to work. So instead, people download it thinking, okay, well this is what's advertised and this is how to install it, let me do that. And then they have an issue, so they report the issue peacefully to the developer, and then instead of getting a helpful response or just saying, oh well, sorry about that, you need to have this program along with it, you get a, you fucking idiot, you need to get education in your own computer's problems. It's like, really? And I almost don't want to use the mod now because of that. Dust form element 0. Due to extreme weather conditions, all traffic to the surface is grounded. Trident's face 4. Okay, cool. Great. But the mod itself, like I said, I got in and I played for like maybe 20 minutes through the introduction sequence just to see how the mod worked. Game runs perfectly fine, everything works, does exactly what I wanted it to. Adds Japanese voices. And I loaded into some other areas like later on in the game with some of my saves, just to see what some of the different scenes were like. And let me tell you something, Balto, a dog cannot make this journey alone, but maybe a wolf can. I had this, the thing with Final Fantasy X is it's one of those, like, it's in one of those gray areas for Final Fantasy, where it's judged quite heavily for two different reasons. Number one, is mainly because it's a very linear Final Fantasy game. It's still quite open, but it's very linear compared to, you know, the overworld map Final Fantasies that you'd normally expect. But it also gets judged quite heavily for the fact that, well, it was the first fully voice-acted Final Fantasy game. So typically, the English voice actors are shit. Now, I grew up with them, so I'm very nostalgic towards them. So obviously, you know, I'm going to recognize all the English voice actors a lot easier. However, ever since I was a kid, I fucking know. Yeah, most of the voice acting on the English side of things is really shit. Specifically with the main character, absolutely terrible most of the time. Sometimes it's good. Some characters though are really, really fucking good, even in the English version. So I was expecting the Japanese version to be just godlike, because if you have an English like dub of an anime that's not too bad, the Japanese version's got to be godlike, right? So I loaded it up, and the fuck? I think this is probably one of the first times I have ever experienced bad Japanese voice acting. It's not awful. It's not all awful. I think it's kind of equal to the English version in that some of it's really good, but some of it's really bad. This is the first time where I can tell that whoever the fuck is doing the voice of the main character again is doing a really awful job. Just as equally to that of the English version of the game. So, I don't know. I thought it'd be cool to have the Japanese voice actors to see, you know, what the original is like. And thinking that maybe it would be a little bit more epic. But, alas. I'll still probably try to play through the game with it anyways. The only other downside of the mod is the fact that all of the dialogue is translated, right? So you have English subtitles, and when you talk to people, when people are speaking in their subtitles, you get all that stuff. It's all in English. But, of course, the voices are in Japanese. However, sometimes in battles, there will be battle dialogue, where somebody will say something, or there will be banter between characters in the middle of a battle. And there is no subtitles on the Japanese or English version. It's purely, simply in the voiced language. So, of course, if you don't know the language, you're not gonna know what the fuck they're saying. So, I mean, obviously I know what they're saying because I've played the game for many, many years. And I've played it so many fucking times. And by so many times, I mean I've never actually beaten it. But, I've gotten straight up to the end so many damn times. And so, I know what most of the banter is, except maybe like the random lines that they say in battle, like, you know, like when Orin says farewell or something like that after a battle ends, when you perform the killing blow, I mean. But yeah, I was really dying to play Final Fantasy X, and then just kind of out of nowhere, I was like, you know, well, because after I got my computer back and it died the very next day, I already told myself that I'm not dealing with the fucking PC anymore. I'm just gonna load up Mass Effect 2 on the laptop and give it a go there. But I didn't get around to doing it right away, obviously. So that came a couple days ago now. But I wasn't exactly planning to do Mass Effect just yet. But then I started it and it was like, oh, yep, we gotta keep fucking doing it now. But yeah, anyways, I installed Final Fantasy X expecting to play through all that, and I didn't even get into it yet. I'll get into it at some point. Maybe if there's a gap between when I finish Mass Effect 2 and having to wait for Mass Effect 3, then perhaps I'll just, like, load up Final Fantasy X to pass the time. Another game that I did load up, however, like about a week ago, was World in Conflict Soviet Assault. And I was really, really worried that about loading this game up because I had it installed on my main hard drive on my main PC, and I had gotten it to work because it's one of those finicky games because it's old. Well, it's older, I should say. It's no longer supported officially. You know, it's like not even owned anymore. That's why when you load up the launcher, it automatically translates in Chinese for some fucking reason. But because of that, it doesn't run very well on newer PCs. And so there's always an issue where it's either crashing or it's not loading right. And I remember I got it to work on the main PC and I left it that way, and I didn't want to uninstall it at all because of that, because I didn't want to have to go through getting it working again. So I was worried that it was going to be the same deal here on the laptop. But no, thankfully, I managed to install. I just installed the expansion, only the expansion, and bam, instantly started working. No problems whatsoever. I've played through about half of the game so far, I think. I think I'm on mission 10 or mission 11. I made it up to. I basically played all of those missions in succession in one sitting. And then just last night I played one more mission, and then I left off. I played that one mission trying to pass the time. And I was gonna play more of it today, like I was gonna finish the anime that I was watching, and then I was gonna play a couple hours of World in Conflict Soviet Assault while I waited for the time to like approach 8 in the morning, and then I was gonna do Mass Effect 2, but obviously that didn't happen. And that's perfectly okay, because getting into the Mass Effect 2s here, 100%. I don't know. I guess I didn't install another game. Recently. I mean, there have been other games that I have been playing, but...
Launching probe. Probe away. Launching probe. Probe away.
Where the fuck were you? There you are.
Probe launched.
That ice cream, though, right? Really good. And that's the problem with fucking dairy. See, I'm lactose intolerant, like, severely. So, unfortunately, I don't have the luxury of really doing the dairy products that much. But it's one of those things where it's kind of like, you know, sometimes you just got to punish yourself a little bit. You get a little reward, whether it be some sort of cheesy product or ice cream or something like that. It's really fucking good. And then 30 minutes later, you're stuck in the bathroom for 20 years in pain. Ugh. It's awful. It's awful, but it's totally worth it. It's totally worth it because that ice cream was really fucking good. It was a vanilla bean, so, of course, my favorite ice cream, just to begin with. But I wanted to put something on it, but we didn't have, like, anything. We didn't have magic shell or, like, nuts or anything to put on it. So I decided to, I had to use something that I guess people probably wouldn't usually think about putting on ice cream. But I put, we had leftover, sugar, cookie sugar, like sugar cookie sugar, in the cupboard. And I just took that blue sugar and I sprinkled some of it into the ice cream, and that's what I ate. And the great thing about it was, is because, yeah, sure, it made it a pretty damn sugary, but the great thing about it was is that the sugar started to melt in the ice cream, or like started to dissolve in the ice cream, I mean. And the great thing about that was is because it was blue sugar, it made it into blue ice cream. Oh, it gave me such a boner. Oh, blue is my favorite color, so fuck you. I don't care if it's a feminine color. Kiss my ass. Or supposedly a feminine color. You know how it is. Pink, blue, apparently feminine. Red, black, apparently not feminine. Or I guess black and white are the neutral colors when it comes to that stuff. I don't know why I've always been attracted to blue. It's been that way since birth. And it's always the same thing with candies. Usually my favorite flavor of like food or candy is always blue. Blueberry, blue raspberry. It's always blue. I have no idea if that has any influence. It just tastes the best to me. Come on, there's got to be some hot spot here that we're missing. Yeah, I don't know if that's really considered a hot spot, but I'll go ahead and drop one.
Probe launched.
Okay, I guess that's what we were missing then. All right, Roger Dodger. Are we saying how many more planets we got? I guess it's just the last planet here. All right, it's the moon. Well, what the f- there.
I have detected an anomaly.
Let's do this in 13 probes. Come on, we've done it before. We can do it again.
Probe away. Probe launched. Launched.
Do, 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 do. Oh shit, I moved it. Right at the line. I did that again. I did that two times last session, too. My ear itches. What the fuck? Not in, it's like the ear lobe. My lobe itches.
jump away. Scans have found something.
There was nothing there. Anomalous detected. Prothean artifacts detected on planet's surface. Artifact site is protected by a powerful energy barrier. Scans detect muted and mechanical signatures consistent with hidden automated defenses. Okay, we'll deal with them here in a little bit. Right now, I'm scanning their fucking planet. Fucking planet. Actually, it's a moon. I don't give a shit. You know what I fucking hate? You know what I fucking hate? Sailor Moon, okay? Now this is why I fucking hate it. There has only ever been one fucking show that has not fucked this up. And believe it or not, it's fucking My Little Pony. There's a princess in My Little Pony named Luna. And she's based off of our moon. It's the only fucking thing that actually calls it Luna. Mass Effect called it Luna as well, so props there.
Probe launched.
Sailor Moon, okay? You got all these characters. You got Sailor Jupiter, Sailor Mercury, Sailor Venus, and then Sailor Moon. It should be Sailor Luna. Moons are moons! You could be referring to any fucking moon. You could be referring to literally any rock that orbits. I guess not, because then there are satellites, because they're too small. Any orb of somewhat large size, right, that orbits another planet is a moon, you motherfucker. Our moon is not called the moon. It's just like our star is not called the sun. It is a sun. It has a name, for fuck's sake, okay? I'm only pointing that out because sometimes people, when they're like, okay, what's the star of our system? The sun? You fucking twat. No. It's the same exact thing with moons, okay? Our moon is not called moon, alright? It has a damn name, okay? It's a very pretty name, too. Luna's a very nice name. That's also why they call it a lunar eclipse. That's why they call it, you know, lunar surface. Because it has a name! You son of a wiener! At least I think that Luna is a name. It'd be funny if I'm ranting about this and it turns out Luna just means moon or something. Yeah, because then I'd be like, well, you're just talking out your ass. If we want to talk about something that isn't talking out of my ass, let's talk about one of the biggest things I like to rant about. When I ranted about this in Far Cry 5, I'm going to rant about it here again because it looks like I'm not going to deplete this place. Oh, maybe I spoke too soon.
Probe launched.
I had just enough probes. Okay, I gotta get this out of my system before we land, guys. Okay, because now that I thought about it, I gotta rant about it. First of all, let me check the recording. Okay, 55 minutes, so it must have cut recently. Alright, I apologize, but I have to make this rant because I was gonna start it. Then we'll stop ranting for a little bit because we're gonna be going under the surface. Okay? Okay. And now this goes to any of you listening right now because I'm sure most of you are guilty of this. But this is one of those really big pet peeves of mine that bothers me so damn much. It is when people call... Okay, oh. Now, it just happened recently in one of the recent Good Mythical Morning videos I watched. Okay, and it is when people call the United States America. Now, the reason that bugs me isn't because they just call it America. It's when they say America. Oh, and then there's Canada, and then, you know, there's Mexico and stuff like that. Sorry, but guess what? North America includes Canada and Mexico. When you say America, you are referring to Mexico, South America, you are referring to Canada, you're also referring to the area that is the United States. When you just say America, or Americas, I guess would be the plural term, because you're talking about both North and South at that point. When you talk about North America, because I hear way too many times people are like, oh yeah, America, or North America, and just above that is Canada. No, I'm sorry. North America is all of those. Mexico is America. Canada is America. The United States is America. It's included. Stop fucking separating them. And then there are the fuckers that think Hawaii isn't part of the United States, or isn't America. Technically, it wasn't in the past. Technically, it shouldn't be, but it is part of the United States. It is a state, therefore it is part of the United States. The same goes for Alaska, but Alaska is still connected to the North America. So stop it! Stop fucking calling it America and then saying, oh yeah, well, yeah, Mexico is not America. Yes, it is. you absolute twat. Okay, I had to get that off my chest. Alright, had to just get it off my chest. It's almost as bad. It's almost, not as bad, but it's almost as bad as people that say especially and museum. Okay, moving. No, enter orbit, we are landing. Jeez, what the fuck was up Tigerfrost's ass when he woke up today? I don't know. There's lots of things that go up my ass. Ah, shit, I shouldn't have said that on the internet. Awkward! Okay, now, anyways. I'm gonna take the same team down that I was setting up before, but I don't know if this is gonna be another one of the vehicle missions or not. Oh, it looks like it is. At least at start. I don't know if there's gonna be areas that we can get off. Oh no, this is a really nice looking place. Perhaps. So this is supposed
kinetic
to be a
barrier detected. Kinetic barrier strength beyond conventional weapon capability. Recommend disabling power sources.
Journal. Okay. Hold on, I wanted to. The dig site is protected by a powerful Prothean kinetic barrier. Holy shit. Power by generator scattered throughout the site, destroying the generator should bring down the field. That's what we gotta do. We gotta find the barrier, or we gotta find the generators. This looks generator up there. Oh, nice. Element zero. Now, see, this is really... Alright, I hear more robots. More drones. I don't need that. What the fuck is this? Is it another one of the Russian Makos? Yeah, okay.
Kinetic barrier strength reduced.
Oh, he's right fucking there, actually.
Kinetic barrier strength reduced.
One left. Don't hit the big pole. My materials, man. Some dig site. Ah, nice. Okay, now we can go on foot, finally. That's okay, put your weapons away.
I think we got them all!
Really? Let's take a look at his... Okay, now his armor looks... Garrus's armor actually looks really fucking cool right now. It looks just like mine. It's nice. It's got glowy blue bits all over it. But the problem with it is right now it looks black and blue, right? Just like mine. That's because he's in the shade. But if we saw, it's actually like a bright silver. And that's what I don't like about it. So we'll have to see it when he's inside some light. Okay, that's not nasty at all. We have here... Is that a... No, that's a blue sun's. I was trying to look to see if... The site is spectacular. Time, however, has proven to be real enemy, even with those blue sun slugs that are there. To erect the shield before the Geth arrived. How can they know our movements almost before we do? Am I beaming my thoughts directly to them? I must find out how they are doing this. I shall ask Dr. Aloy for whatever help he can provide. Element zero. it sounds kind of bonerific. Didn't think we'd be walking around Prothean ruins again anytime soon. Oh, I just realized those little bugs on the ground are the same bugs from... Hold on, let me see. Those look like the same creatures that we saw on that planet in the first game. Oh, sort of. Oh, okay. Oh, I know I wasted a shot. I just wanted to see invincible bugs. Oops. Damn it.
We're done here.
Dr. Aloy must have been indoctrinated by the Reapers.
What?
I found him sending our data to a Geth ship. I won't be responsible for another Geth attack. Another Eden Prime. I've silenced Aloy. Forever.
Huh. Okay, something fishy is going on here. That's a blue sun. Whoops, I didn't mean to. Why did it pull out the shotgun again? I switched to the fucking assault rifle! I'll just steal his money. He doesn't need it.
This might be useful.
Biotic damage. Use the research computer. Okay, that's new.
It's too late for me. They're still in my head, stealing my thoughts. I can't keep them out. I've got no choice but to destroy this relic. And myself.
Nice, we haven't done one of these in a while. Oh, it's this one. Yeah, okay. I was almost getting confused there for a second. Now, we've had an experience with a big orb before in the first game where we've passed out and had this experience. Dr. Sace would never understand the deal I made with the collectors. What? It's obsessed with these... he's obsessed with these Protheans. He would sacrifice everything to learn their secrets. It nearly cost me my life, but I did it for you, Helen, to ensure you remained safe. The damned collectors agreed to spare your colony in exchange for this Prothean find. I can only hope you remained innocent of any of this ugly business. It was all for you, Dr. Robert Aloy. Well, he has now been turned into a burnt thing, so... That noise that it's making. Cutscene! Okay. Don't touch it! It looks like Sin from Final Fantasy X when he's in his big water ball. What? Look like the little balls that we pulled off of that other planet when we were fighting the Geth. So apparently the big balls can turn into little balls. Prothean artifact recovered, okay. Experience, yeah, barely any. Plus 10% biotic damage, yeah. Credits, a little bit. Element zero, that's good, okay. Well shit, what now? Is there another Firewalker mission that's gonna pop up? I'd assume not, because it's just been shown that both of them are dead. Both of the doctors, at least. Are we going to learn? Maybe we'll get a terminal message or something to give me some answers as to what the fuck. If there's anything special about that artifact, or...
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Glad you're okay. Kate Bowman? Who's Kate Bowman? Shepard, I called in some favors and found out how to get you... How to get you and what you're working on. We've got a big celebration planned for the anniversary of you and the others saving Terra Nova. Last year we added a memorial for you too. I guess that was premature, huh? I figure finding out who's attacking colonies is why you had to go undercover, so I won't invite you to come give a speech or anything. But I wanted you to know that if Lipsianus colonies were what's happening in the Terminus systems, I'm really glad you're here there to help. There's a lot of crazy military talk going on. I'm glad someone's out there! Damn it! Someone's there who's not going to take the easy way out. Thanks, Kate Bowman. That sounds very familiar. That didn't have anything to do with that asteroid mission, did it? Because that's where I keep thinking I heard a Kate. It says Terra Nova, but I remember the name, but I don't remember what it was relating to. Alright, here we go. Martin Burns. Commander Shepard, Udina said this would reach you. I wanted you to know that I haven't forgotten what you did for me the day those crazy biotics took me hostage. You talked them down and you got me off that ship alive. I won't lie to you, I took this job for the pull and the power. I saw the biotics issue as a stepping stone, something good to put on my resume. And I was wrong. We all serve humanity in our own way. I don't know what you're doing, but I'm going to see to it that humanity reaches its potential with a minimum of bloodshed. I'm getting letters of thanks from L2 biotics who just received their reparations. Those letters should really be coming to you. I just thought you should know. Good luck, I've taken some political heat, so I don't know that any offer to help you would ever be useful. But if you need me, I won't let you down. Martin Burns, Chairman, Subcommittee for Transhuman Studies. Historic discovery. Okay, here we go. The burst of energy that coincided, with your retrieval of the Prothean artifact contained coded information. Most of the data was beyond our ability to track, but the threads we were able to decrypt have provided new avenues for research on energy transfer and biotics. It will keep the scientists busy for years to come. The data indicates that the artifact is currently inert and not dangerous. We wonder, however, that if Dr. Sace had more time, would he have unlocked its secrets? We will continue his research. A landmark find for humanity. Good work, Shepard. Great, so it was just useless. okay. Now, I don't know if anyone's going to have new stuff to say, but we'll go talk just to see. Ding! What the hell is this? Oh my god, what the fuck? The relic is just with me. It undulates when I touch it. Okay, okay, just added something new to my thing. How many ships are missing here? I don't know, it looks like maybe 2, 3? Well, if you look at the pins up there, that would be 1. Pins down here would be 2, 3. Then we got 1 pin there. What the fuck is the 1 pin gonna do? Must be a really shitty ship. And possibly 1 over there, too. So, I don't know.
Bumped into Zaid recently. Quite the character. Given how much violence and destruction that man's seen, he's surprisingly well adjusted. Still, I wouldn't want to be alone with him. Anyway, what's up?
Is there anything I should know?
Nothing right now.
Okay.
Anything else, Commander?
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Let's go see. We'll talk to Jacob first.
Commander, can I help you with something?
I'm more interested in just talking for a bit.
Already? I'm not big on forcing these talks, Shepard. Let's do this later.
Okay.
We'll talk later.
Alright.
Commander.
I don't know if anything's going to be new. We'll talk to Morden quick. If he's got something new to say, well, we'll see.
Shepard, how can I help?
Have you got a minute to talk?
Not at the moment. Think I've unlocked collector interest in humans. Wait, no. Only one heart. Krogan have two. Scratch that.
Damn
Anything
it.
Anything else?
I'll let you work.
We'll be
Shit,
here.
Shit, they could have. He could have revealed the whole story right here, right now. We wouldn't even have to finish the game. We just know. All right. Okay. So I don't think anyone's gonna have anything new to say. Let's go ahead and look at our journal.